Paiton, those guys always seem to play you tough. Mm-hmm. Is there is it just a good matchup for them, a tough matchup for you guys? Why do you think that is?
I think they're just a really hardworking team. I mean, it's no surprise that they come out and they work their hardest, especially playing in an environment like this. It was impressive how hard they played, and they made us work for it. So,
Maya, you guys went up by, I think, 21, and then they got it down to 10 at the end of the third. Was there frustration on your guys' part that they had cut back into that lead, or was it sort of like, hey, these guys are here to play, and we got a game going here?
Yeah, I think it was. Obviously, we respect them as a team. They have a lot of really good athletes. Like Paiton said, they play really hard. And so basketball is a game of runs, and they kind of made their run in the third quarter. But I thought we did a good job of just staying together and making our run there in the fourth.
How did they go on that run? What were they doing?
I mean, they hit a lot of good shots. I think we kind of let down defensively and maybe didn't make the right reads a few times. But runs happen in basketball games, and I thought we responded well.
Maya, you guys have shot the ball well from three this year. Something you guys kind of struggled with last year. What do you think switched for you guys in the offseason?
Yeah, honestly, girls got in the gym. We spent a lot of time. Our coaches they devote a lot of time into us, and so I thought that's just a credit to our offseason work and how much time we've spent in the gym, and it's fun to see all that hard work pay off this year.
And you guys have won 9 straight now. How confident are you guys right now as you head into these final 4 games of conference play?
Definitely feels good to have 9 straight wins, but that doesn't mean the next game isn't going to be just as hard as the last 9 that we've played. So just coming to practice in every game, ready to go, and then work our hardest.
Good win for us. I thought we played well in a lot of ways. I thought Omaha played really well. Obviously, they made shots. 10 of 18 from the 3-point line is exactly what they needed, and they played well offensively. On the other side, honestly, I thought we played really well offensively too. I thought we missed some good looks. I thought we had a lot of easy shots or jump shots, and some went in, some didn't. But Omaha did a nice job of hanging in there and making plays when they needed to. But I still feel really good about how we played, and this has been a good kind of 3-game stretch for us here in Frost Arena.
You alluded to it on Thursday that these guys always just play tough. Why do you think that is? Is it just a good matchup for them, or?
Well, I think their style of play, they're certainly very methodical. They kind of grind out half-court possessions. We like to probably be a little quicker up and down, so I think the pace of the game is a little bit different. And I think their size and physicality inside is hard for us because that's where we want to go and score. We still got 28 points in the paint, but you could see we also took a lot of threes, and some of that's because of what they gave us, but also because they're hard to score on inside. So it's always been a competitive matchup. But I do feel like, again, we played really well. Getting to 77 points against them is not easy, but I thought we did a nice job offensively.
Did you not defend the 3-point line as well as you'd like to? Did they have you chasing? What kind of led to that?
Well, they were good in their ball screens. Our plan there was mixed, I guess I would say. I mean, at times I thought it was good. Late in that second half, they obviously were pouring in threes. We needed to adjust, and we did for the last probably 3-4 minutes, and I think that helped. But they had some people step up and make shots that really kept them in it. So that ball screen plan, if we see them again, would have to be probably a little bit different. But it's hard. You can really commit to that 3-point line, and they're good inside too. So you got to pick and choose a little bit. And they took advantage of what we gave them today.
Maya almost had a triple-double. I mean, maybe you don't notice as much if she doesn't score 30, but she was kind of all over the place tonight.
Yeah, we'll talk to her about that. A couple assists and rebounds there. But she's getting into such a good rhythm. She looks like she's moving really well, looks really confident, looks really assertive, like she's very much in control of what's going on. And she's doing great. I think the team is responding, really well. Around her, you still have a group of people that on any given day can step up and get you, 16, 17 points. You saw that from Paiton today. She really stretched the floor and is doing a great job there. Paige, I thought, was really good in what she had to get done. Tylee had stretches where she was really assertive when we needed her. So, it's a good group, and they're playing really well.
You guys are playing really well right now. Is there anything you'd like to see more from your team as you head into this final 4 games?
Yeah, I think consistency with some of our game plan execution stuff. I think sometimes we can get going a little bit quick and take what's in front of us rather than what we're probably needing to get. Some of that's player movement, some of that's ball movement, whatever it might be, whatever we're trying to get to. Same thing defensively. How can we recognize scenarios a little bit better and take advantage of them? But I think our effort's been really good. Our unselfishness has been really good. We're moving the ball, sharing it really well. And now this time of year, it's really about trying to, I think, kind of see what teams are trying to do to attack us and what we need to do and being really sharp with those things.
Who's your Super Bowl pick?
Ooh, I'm indifferent on this one. Usually I have pretty strong feelings, but I don't know that I have a real big winner. But my son Dylan, he's all about the Bengals, so I'm going to keep it in the family and go with the Bengals here.